In my experience, I find that custom dimensions and metrics are one of the most underused features of Universal, and they can be incredibly useful for your analytics deployments. For example, in a lot of our analytics deployments, we'll set the Google Tag Manager container ID as a custom dimension, which means that we know exactly how that data got into Google Analytics in the first place. Simo Ahava has an excellent post on useful custom dimensions for Universal that you can check out at this link. We've used many of these dimensions for our clients' analytics implementations over the years, but now with GA4, we of course need to rethink how we are using custom dimensions and metrics. These custom definitions have been overhauled in GA4, which means you can't just take what you had in Universal and move it over to GA4. In Universal, there were four possible scopes of custom dimensions: hit, session, user, and product. But in GA4, the custom dimensions only have the scope options of user or event, nothing in between. If you had session or product custom dimensions Universal, you'll have to do a bit of thinking to see how you can move them over to GA4. As for custom metrics, you had the scopes of hit or product, and the metric could be formatted as integer, currency, or time. In GA4, you don't have the product scope any longer, but you do have a lot more options for the unit of measurement. One great new feature is that, unlike the previous limit of 20 dimensions and 20 metrics, you can now create 100 event-scoped custom dimensions or metrics and 25 user-scoped. And unlike Universal, you can archive definitions that you are no longer using. But note that if you do this, you cannot recover it. For product-scoped dimensions and metrics, Google would like you to use their recommended events, which you can find here at this link. As for session scope dimensions, in a lot of cases, you can probably just turn these into hit or user scope dimensions without any issues. For example, a common session scoped custom dimension I would see is if the user is logged in or not. I would suggest that you could either make that user scoped and use the user ID feature, or make it event scoped just to record the fact that someone did actually sign in. User scope dimensions can be remade in GA4, but there is one important change. In Universal, if a user scope dimension was set in the middle of the session, the dimension was applied to every event of the same session, even for things that happened before the user dimension was set. In GA4, user scope dimensions are set for all the events, but only from the moment it's set onwards. Past events are not modified. To create a user scoped custom dimension in GA4, you can use the GA4 configuration tag in Google Tag Manager and then add the information in the user property section. If your user property won't be set right away at page load, but perhaps with a different trigger, you can create an additional GA4 configuration tag specifically to set that user scoped custom dimension. Just make sure to uncheck the Send to Page View event when this configuration loads checkbox, or else you could end up double counting page views. The most common use of a custom dimension is along with an event. Let's say, for example, you want to track specific elements that are clicked on a page. In this example, I'll be using the Kickpoint website, and we have a rocket ship at the bottom of each page that we track clicks or taps on. This is what the event looks like when it goes off to GA4, with an event name of UI engagement and an element name of rocket ship. Now, the element name parameter isn't in the list of automatically collected information. It's something new that we made up. So in order for this to show up in reports, we need to add it as a custom dimension. Obviously, this is very different from how custom dimensions worked in Universal. To add a new dimension, go to Configure, Custom Definitions, and then click Create Custom Dimensions. Then enter your dimension name and which event parameter corresponds to. You don't need to name the dimension the same as the event parameter, but I have been in order to keep things simple. Custom metrics are set up in exactly the same way, just under the Custom Metrics section instead. You can see here how many more options we have for the unit of measurement, lots of interesting possibilities. Now that you have registered your custom dimensions and metrics, within 24 hours you should see them in the various reports as you use GA4. And of course, don't forget to record these on your tracking sheet.